Hello children, good morning. Today let us do the revision of chapter number 4, Paths and Holes. Children, let us revise chapter number 4, Paths and Holes today. You learned to identify the fraction as a part of a whole or a part of a collection. You also learned different types of fractions, which are proper and improper fractions, unit fractions, mixed fractions, like and unlike fractions, and equivalent fractions. You also learned how to find equivalent fractions of a fraction and how to represent the fractions pictorially, to find the lowest term of a fraction, that is, lowest terms means simplification of fractions, and to compare like fractions. Children, you also learned to compare like fractions, addition and subtraction of like fractions, multiplication of fractions, and you learn to find fraction of a number. Finally, you learn to convert improper fractions into mixed fractions and vice versa. There were lots of topics which we covered in this chapter. Let us now revise each topic. Children, shall we start the revision of paths and holes? Okay. What are paths and holes? When a whole object is divided into parts. And now what are fractions? Fraction represents equal parts of a whole or a collection. The parts should be equal. And this is a whole and this is a collection. First, let us see what is a fraction of a whole. I have got a sheet of paper and I have divided this sheet of paper into four equal parts. Two portions are colored red, one portion is of brown color and one portion is of purple color. Now, what is the fraction of red portion in this whole? If you see, as two portions are colored red, it will be 2 upon 4. 4 is the total number of portions. So, the fraction for the red color will be 2 upon 4. And for purple color, it will be 1 upon 4. One portion colored out of 4 portions. Now, let us see fraction of a collection. I've got few crystals here. 10 to be precise. I'm having 10 crystals. 2 pink color, 5 blue color and 3 green color. Now if I ask you, what is the fraction of the blue colored crystal? What will you say? As I have 5 blue crystals out of 10, my fraction for blue colored crystal will be 5 upon total. That is 5 upon 10. And for pink crystals, it will be 2 upon 10. 2 upon the total. And for green crystals, it will be 3 upon 10, the total. So this is how you see the fraction of a whole and fraction of a collection. Followed? Children, you know what is a fraction. Fraction can be a part of a whole or a collection. Fraction has a numerator and a denominator. The numerator tells the number of equal parts taken and the denominator tells the total number of equal parts in a whole or a collection. Children, let us now revise how to represent the fraction pictorially. Can you see a circle here which is divided into four equal parts? And out of these four equal parts, one portion is colored. So if I ask you, what is the fraction of the colored portion, what will it be? It will be 1/4. And what will be the fraction of the white portion? It will be 3/4. That is, three portions out of four portions are white in color. Okay. Let us do few questions. First question. Write the fraction of the colored part of each figure. In the first figure, out of 4, 3 are colored. So it is 3 upon 4. In the second, out of 6, 5 are colored. So it is 5 upon 6. In the third, out of 3, 2 are colored. So it is 2 upon 3. In the last figure, if you see, the first circle, 2 upon 2 is colored. So in the second figure, 1 is colored, 1 upon 2. So 2 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2 will be 3 upon 2. You can even write 1 full plus half, 1 and a half. And the second question, write the fraction of the white portion of each figure. In the first, out of 6 portions, 1 is in white color, that is 1 upon 6. In the second, out of 2, 1 is in white color, so it is 1 upon 2. In the third, out of 5, 3 are white in color, so 3 upon 5. And the final figure, out of 5, 1 is in white color, so 1 upon 5. Okay kids, let's now see the different types of fractions. Proper and improper fractions. What is a proper fraction? When a fraction is less than 1 or whole, it is called a proper fraction. The numerator is always less than the denominator here. Example, 1/4, half, 3/4, etc. And when a fraction is equal to a whole or more, then it is called an improper fraction. Here the numerator is always more than or equal to the denominator. Example, 7 upon 7, 9 upon 4, 12 upon 5, etc. Following. Next is unit fractions and mixed fractions. What is a unit fraction? A proper fraction with 1 as the numerator is called an unit fraction. What is a proper fraction? A fraction where the numerator is always less than the denominator. Example of unit fractions, 1 upon 6, 1 upon 9, etc. Mixed fractions, a fraction that is a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction is called a mixed fraction. Example, 2, 1 upon 5, 4, 3 upon 8, etc. Here in 2 and 1 upon 5, 2 is the whole number and 1 upon 5 is the proper fraction. Children, let us now see what are like and unlike fractions and equivalent fractions and also how to compare like fractions. Fractions with the same denominator are called like fractions. Example, 2 upon 3, 5 upon 3, etc. Fractions with different denominators are called unlike fractions. Example, 1 upon 8, 4 upon 7, 3 upon 5, etc. Now, two or more fractions that represent the same share are called equivalent fractions. You can see an example here. 2 upon 7, when I multiply the numerator and the denominator with the same number, that is 2 here, I get 4 upon 14. So I can say one of the equivalent fraction of 2 upon 7 is 4 upon 14. Equivalent fractions will have the same value. Now, how to compare the fractions? You know how to compare the numbers. You put greater than or less than sign. So to compare like fractions, compare the numerators. The greater the numerator, the greater the fraction. For example, compare 4 upon 7 and 2 upon 7. So here, 4 upon 7 is greater than 2 upon 7. Are you all getting it, children? Children, let us now see how to find equivalent fractions of a fraction. Let us find two equivalent fractions of 2 upon 5. To find the equivalent fractions, we have to multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number. So let us now find two equivalent fractions, 2 upon 5. First, I am going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2. What will I get? 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. So this is my first equivalent fraction. Second, I am going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by 3. What will I get? 6 upon 50. Now try and find out one more on your own. So I can say that the equivalent fractions of 2 upon 5 are 4 upon 10 and 6 upon 50. It is easy, no? Children, let us do few practical questions on the topics which we covered till now. Okay, now you can see certain fractions given here. You have to put these fractions under the appropriate columns. What are proper fractions? Fractions where the numerator is always less than the denominator. Improper fractions, fractions where the numerator is either equal to or more than the denominator. Then unit fractions, it is a proper fraction having 1 as the numerator. And mixed fractions, a fraction having a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. Okay, let's start doing this now. 1 upon 6, it is a proper fraction. The numerator is less than the denominator. Now 7 upon 19, again it is a proper fraction. Numerator is less than the denominator. 11 upon 3, it is improper fraction. 1 and 2 upon 7, mixed. Now 6 upon 5, here the numerator is more than the denominator. So it is improper fraction. 1 upon 14, okay, sorry, this 1 upon 6 will also come in unit fraction as the numerator is 1. Now let us come to 1 upon 14. 1 upon 14 will come here and also here. 5 and 8 upon 9, mixed fraction. 9 upon 9, the numerator is equal to the denominator, it is an improper fraction. 26 upon 15, again improper fraction. 4 upon 7, proper fraction. Now 1 upon 23 will again come here in proper fractions and under unit fraction. Are you following? Okay, children, let us go to the next. Say whether the following given fractions are like fractions or unlike fractions. What are like and unlike fractions? Fractions having the same denominator are like fractions, and fractions having different denominators are unlike fractions. So let us do this now. In the first question A, the denominator is same. So, it is a like fraction. Second one, they are all different, unlike fraction. Third, again the denominators are different, so unlike fractions. In D, again it is, the denominators are different. And in E, the denominators are same, so it is like fraction. This is simple. Yeah? Okay, children. Let us now find two equivalent fractions for the following. How to find the equivalent fractions? You just have to multiply the numerator and the denominator with the same number. Simple. The number can be any number. So let us now find equivalent fractions for 5 upon 6. I'm just going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by 3. What will I get? 15 upon 18. Now second, I am going to multiply it by 10. It is 50 upon 60. So I can say the two equivalent fractions of 5 upon 6 are 15 upon 18 and 50 upon 60. Okay. Now, for 7 upon 9, I am going to multiply it by 2. So, 14 upon 18. And here, I am going to multiply it with 7. 49 upon 63. So, 7 upon 9 will be equal to 14 upon 18, and the second one 49 upon 63. So these are the equivalent fractions for 7 upon 9. Now I have given you two questions. Try it out yourself. To do these questions, be thorough with your table. Okay. Kids, next is comparing the like fractions. What are like fractions? fractions having the same denominator. You already know how to compare two numbers. This is same as that only, comparing two numbers. Only thing is, here you have to compare the numerators. The greater the numerator, the fraction will be greater. So let us see here, 12 upon 20 and 17 upon 20. Here if you compare the numerators, 17 upon 20 is greater than 12 upon 20 because 17 is greater than 12. So you put the sign like this. Now for the second question, 9 upon 10 and 14 upon 10. Now again if you see, 14 is greater than 9. So it will be like this. Now I have given you two questions. Try these two. Okay. Okay children, let us now see how to add and subtract the like fractions and how to multiply the fractions. To add the like fractions, add the numerators and write the sum as numerator over the same denominator. Let us take an example here. 1 upon 18 plus 7 upon 18 plus 2 upon 18 will give us 10 upon 18. That is 1 plus 7 plus 2, which is equal to 10, and the same denominator 18. Whenever you see a fraction which can be reduced, then please reduce it. Here both 10 and 18 comes in the table of 2. 5 2s are 10, 9 2s are 18. So this 10 upon 18 can be reduced to 5 upon 9. Now to subtract the like fractions, subtract the numerators and write the difference as the numerator over the same denominator. For example, 7 upon 18 minus 5 upon 18 will give 2 upon 18. Again here, 2 and 18 both comes in the table of 2. So it can be reduced to 1 upon 9. Now, to multiply the fractions, multiply the numerators of the fractions to get the new numerator and multiply the denominators of the fractions to get the new denominator. Simplify if possible again here. For example, 7 upon 5 into 2 upon 7 will give 14 upon 35. 7 2s are 14, 5 7s are 35. Now, both these numbers comes in the table of 7. 7 2s are 14 and 7 5s are 35. So this can be reduced to 2 upon 5. Okay children, let us do now the lowest term of a fraction. What is the lowest term of a fraction? You just have to simplify the given fraction. Let us find the lowest term of 28 upon 32. Now if you see, both are even numbers. That means both the numbers will come in the table of 2. So it is 14 2s are 28 and 16 2s are 32. Now again if you see, these two are even numbers. So again it will come in table 2. 7 2s are 14 and 8 2s are 16. Now, is there any number except 1 that can further divide these two numbers? No. So, we say 7 upon 8 is the lowest term of the fraction of 28 upon 32. But suppose you are thorough with your tables, you will be able to know that these two numbers come in table 4. 7 4s are 28 and 8 4s are 32. You can do it directly also, just by cutting these two and writing 7 upon 8. So for simplifying the fraction, you should be very very thorough with your tables. Keep on learning your tables every day. And by practice, it will come to you. Okay? Okay children, shall we do few questions to find the lowest term of a fraction? Okay, the first question I have given is 18 upon 27. Now, this is an even number, but this is an odd number. So, we will not find 27 in table 2. Now, let us see in which table both these numbers come. These numbers come in table 3. So, you can say 6 3s are 18 and 9 3s are 27. Now, again if you see, these two numbers will come in table 3. 2 3s are 6, 3 threes are 9. Now, can you reduce this? No. So, this is the simplified form of 18 upon 27. You can directly also write, just cut these two, you can write 2 upon 3. Both comes in table 9. 9 twos are 18, 9 threes are 27. Now, let us come to this second part, 25 upon 30. This is very simple. Both the numbers come in table 5. 5 5s are 25, 6 5s are 30. Now, these two numbers, can you simplify it more? No. So, we will leave it like this. 3 upon 24. Again, it is very simple. 1 3s are 3, 8 3s are 24. So, now, I have given you two questions here. Please try it out. Be thorough with your tables again. I am telling you again and again. Be thorough with your tables. You can do it faster that way. Okay. Children, you learned how to add and subtract the like fractions and also how to multiply two fractions. To add the like fractions, we have to add the numerators and write the sum as the new numerator with the same denominator. And to subtract, you have to subtract the two numerators, write the difference in the numerator and the same denominator. For multiplying two fractions, you have to multiply the numerators and write the number, new number in the numerator, and multiply the denominators and write the new number in the denominator. But when you multiply two fractions, if the final answer can be reduced or simplified, you have to reduce it. So for that, I am going to do 2-3 questions here. Let us solve these questions and reduce the fraction if possible. Now, there are two ways to do this. Either first multiply the numerators, 2 into 1, 2, 4 threes are 12. Now you know both of them are even numbers and 12 comes in table of 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 sixes are 12. So, it is 1 upon 6. Now, if you see, you cannot reduce it anymore. So, we will leave it like this. Instead of doing this way, you can directly do it here. 2 and 4 are even numbers. And 4 comes in the table of 2. So, we can cut like this. Write 1 here. Write 2 here. So, what will it be? 1 into 1. 3 into in the denominator, which is equal to 1 upon 6. Both ways are okay. You can do any method you want. Now let us go here. Now I am going to directly cut here itself. 7 1s are 7, 7 1s are 7. So what I have in the numerator now? I have 2 into 1, this one, by this one into 9. It is 2 upon 9. Can you reduce it further? No. So, we will leave it like this. Now, come here. Now, these two are even numbers. 2 2s are 4. 4 2s are 8. 2 is common between them. Now, again, if you see, 2 is common between them. 2 1s are 2. 2 2s are 4. Right? Now, see these two numbers. 21 comes in table of 3. 3 1s are 3. 3 7s are 21. So, it is 1 into 2 divided by 1 into 7, which is equal to 2 upon 7. Or you can do it the other way. 8 3s are 24 divided by 21 4s are 84. Now, you can cut. Okay. It comes in table 12. 12 2s are 24 and 12 7s are 84. 2 upon 7. Now you cannot reduce this anymore. So this is the answer. Reducing the fraction needs thorough in table. So with practice, it will be easier for you. Children, here are few questions for you to practice. Addition and subtraction of like fractions and also for multiplication of fractions. While doing the multiplication of fractions, try to reduce the answer or simplify the answer if possible. Children, let us take a new topic now, fraction of a number. Finding a fraction of a number is same as multiplying the number and the fraction. Let us take an example here, 3 upon 5 into 10. You just have to multiply this fraction with this number. While multiplying, this 10 will be your numerator. It will become 10 upon 1. 10 upon 1 is 10 only. So now you know how to multiply the two fractions? Yes. 5 and 10. What is common between them? 5. 10 comes in table of 5. So 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. So it is equal to 3 into 2, which is equal to 6. So this is how you do find the fraction of a number. Let us now take two examples here. Let us solve these two. We have to find 5 upon 7 of a week. We have to write in days. How many days in a week? 7 days. Right? So now we'll find 5 upon 7 into 7. Now this is the numerator and this is the denominator. We can cancel these two. 7 ones are 7, 7 ones are 7, which is equal to 5 into 1 divided by 1, which is equal to 5. And you have to write days here. What is this 5? 5 days. So 5 seventh of a week is 5 days. Now let us do this. 2 upon 9 into 81. If you cancel these two, 9 ones are 9, 9 nines are 81, 9 twos are 80. So this is how you calculate fraction of a number. I have given you two questions here. Try to do this. Leap year. How many days in a leap year? Yes, 366. So 1/6 of 366. Again, you have to write days here. And you have to find 2/3 of 15 kilometers. So whatever comes, you have to write that many kilometers. So please try it. Kids, let us do some problem sums. Question number 1. Dhruv has rupees 240. He spends 3 upon 8 of the money to buy a book. What is the price of the book? Okay, let us solve it. Money with Dhruv is rupees 240. Fraction of the money spent on the book is 3 upon 8. So now what will be the price of the book? 3 upon 8 of 240. Now 8 threes are 24. So 38 will be 240. I can cut this. It is 3 into 30 upon 1. 3 30s are 90. So the price of the book will be rupees 90. Okay. Children, let us now solve one more problem. A movie hall has 500 seats. 3 upon 5 of the seats are occupied. How many seats are vacant? Now, the total number of seats are 500. Fraction of the seats occupied will be 3 upon 5. So, number of seats occupied will be 500 into 3 upon 5. I can cut these two. 5 ones are 5. 500s are 500. So, it is 100 into 300 upon 1, which is equal to 300. Okay, now therefore the number of seats vacant will be how much? 500 is the total seats. Number of seats occupied is 300. So number of seats vacant will be 200. So answer will be 200 seats are vacant. Two halves will make a whole, four quarters will make a whole, and 8 1/8 will make a whole. Two quarters will make a half, 4 1/8 will make a half. Finally, 2 1/8 will make a quarter. Then 2 50 paise will be equal to 1 rupee, 4 25 paise will be equal to 1 rupee, 5 20 paise will be equal to 1 rupee, and 10 10 paise will be equal to 1 rupee. Children, let us revise the conversion of mixed and improper fractions now. First, let us convert the mixed fraction to improper fraction. Whole number into denominator plus the numerator upon the denominator. Let us take an example here. Convert 3 and 3 upon 4 to improper fraction. So, whole number, which is 3, into the denominator, which is 4, plus the numerator, which is again 3, upon the denominator 4, equal to 3 fours are 12 plus 3 upon 4, which is 15 upon 4. So 3 and 3 upon 4 converted into improper fraction as 15 upon 4. Now let us convert improper fraction to mixed fraction. Example, convert 12 upon 5 to mixed fraction. Here we will divide. So when we divide, we get the quotient as 2 and remainder as 2. The quotient will be our whole number, the remainder will be our numerator of the proper fraction, and the divisor will be the denominator of the proper fraction. So when 12 upon 5 is converted into mixed fraction, it will be 2 the quotient and 2 upon 5. Here the 2 is the remainder and 5 is the divisor. Children, let us do some questions on conversion now, that is converting an improper fraction to a mixed fraction and vice versa. The first question is, convert 21 upon 5 to mixed fraction. How do we convert this? We need to divide it. Five fours are 20. What is the remainder? 1. So now what will be my mixed fraction? My quotient will be my whole number. My remainder will be the numerator of the proper fraction, and the divisor will be the denominator. So 21 upon 5 is equal to 4 and 1 upon 5. Now let us come to the second question. Now convert 6 2 upon 3 to improper fraction. How do we convert this? Whole number into the denominator plus the numerator upon the same denominator, that is 3, which is equal to 6 3s are 18, 18 plus 2, 20 upon 3. You can orally also confirm if your answer is right. 6 3s are 18, 18 plus 2, 20, 20 upon 3. Here too you can do this. 5 4s are 20, 20 plus 1, 21, 21 upon 5. Okay, now the third question. Again the same formula. Whole number into denominator plus the numerator upon the same denominator, which is equal to 10 4s are 40, 40 plus 3, 43, 43 upon 4. 10 4s are 40, 40 plus 3, 43, 43 upon 4. Now the final question. Again we have to divide it here. 6 3s are 18. What is the remainder? 2. So the fraction will be, my quotient will be my whole number, remainder the numerator of the proper fraction, and divisor the denominator of the proper fraction. Now let us see. 6 3s are 18. 18 plus 2, 20. 20 upon 3. Okay. If you practice, it will come faster to you. I have given you two questions here. The first question, you have to convert this to mixed fraction. And the second question, this mixed fraction is to be converted to improper fraction. Try it. Try and do it. Children, try to do these two problem sums on your own. Question number 1. The price list of items rice, sugar and tea are given, which are rupees 70, rupees 45 and rupees 60 respectively. You can also see Ria's shopping list is given to you. Find out how much money will Ria pay for these groceries. Question number 2. Seema reads 2/9 of a book in the morning and 3/9 of the book in the evening. How much does she read in the entire day? Children, we have come to the end of this revision session now. Solve all the questions I have given after each topic. Be thorough with your tables. Revise the whole chapter thoroughly. Take care and bye.